KTM's adventure lineup in India has become that much more affordable and accessible with the arrival of the 250 Adventure. So is it wise to save and get the 250 Adventure or spend that 50,000 rupees extra and get the 390? Well, that's what we are here to find out and also let you know which one is the better suited bike for you. No, it isn't. Since both the motorcycles share the same frame and mechanical setup, the seat height continues to remain an alarmingly high 855 mm. So riders who are shorter than 5 feet 6 inches will continue to tiptoe on this motorcycle. But should that stop you from buying it? We don't think so. To cruise at 100 km/h, the 250 certainly feels better, as the 390 does egg you on to ride that bit faster. Whereas on this bike, you can ride it at a relatively sedate pace. However, if you get stuck behind traffic on the highway, this does require to downshift one or two gears to get the move done. Whereas on the 390, there is loads more power and torque available, so you can get the move done by a simple roll of the throttle. Needless to say, highway fuel efficiency is better on the 250. The same harsh suspension setup from the 390 Adventure makes its way onto the 250 as well. So that means to get the best out of these units, you need to be riding this bike at a quick pace. That said, the 250 motor here, the power delivery of this engine is more friendly and accessible. That means you always remain in control of the bike, rather than having an overwhelming experience that you find on the 390. Plus, there are no electronic nannies over here to hamper your off-road experience. Not really. The features that you want for adventure touring are there, like switchable ABS, a 12-volt charging socket, and a provision for phone or a GPS mount. Traction control never did enhance the ride experience on the 390 that much, so it is good that it isn't hampering the experience here. It could have got the LED headlight, considering its price tag, and also the fact that the 250 Duke, from which this engine is borrowed, now comes with the advanced illumination system. Given that this is the entry-level KTM adventure motorcycle in India, it does do a decent job in the city as well as out on the highway. It isn't as exciting or involving to ride as the 390, but for majority of the public, this will get the job done. We just wish it got an LED headlight. And also, it could have had the 390's sintered brake pads, as the brake bite and lever feel on the 250 is a bit lacking. Braking distances are reasonably short, but they could have been better with sintered pads. The 390 Adventure is a noise tool for fast highway riding. And if you're looking for something like that, it's well worth the extra moolah. For fast off-road riding, you are better off getting the 250 Adventure. Now don't get us wrong, neither one of these is an outright trail bike. But of the two, the 250 Adventure feels easier to ride on the rough stuff. But if you are going to be spending majority of your time on tarmac and still want a KTM motorcycle, you could save a lakh over this and half a lakh over this and get the 250 Duke. So is it a wise choice to save the 50,000 and who are 5 feet 6 inches of short? Wait, that also, wait, sorry, sorry. That remains, sorry. And they will tiptoe, sorry. And will get the work done for majority, sorry. It does do, sorry.
24 patties.
इनमें से कुछ भी नहीं बिका सर।
क्या सेल करेगा जिमी? 20 साल में कभी ऐसा नहीं देखा है। नो कस्टमर्स, नो सेल।
कार देखो गाड़ी पे होम इंस्पेक्शन बुक करो और कार बेचो ऑफिस घर या कहीं से भी और पाओ बेस्ट प्राइस क्विक पेमेंट फ्री आरसी ट्रांसफर एंड डॉक्यूमेंटेशन।
आज से तुम यहाँ पे वेटर नहीं डिलीवरी बॉय भी। अभी जा अभी जा।
कार देखो गाड़ी पे होम इंस्पेक्शन बुक करो और बेस्ट प्राइस पे कार बेचो कहीं से भी। गाड़ी फॉरवर्ड तो इंडिया फॉरवर्ड।